There's a framework I've been keeping a close eye on because it has a new and a clever approach to the problem that Next.js, Astro and others are trying to solve. That framework is called Qwik. It's the brainchild of Mishko Hevery, who created Angular. And Qwik has just left beta and reached version 1.0. Let's take a look at the following. First, why Qwik's approach is so promising. Second, how other frameworks have inspired Qwik. And three, how Qwik compares to other JavaScript frameworks, particularly React, Next.js and Solid.js. But first, what is the problem that Qwik is trying to solve? As web developers, we want to develop the best user experience possible. User experience is about two things mainly: making websites interactive and making them responsive. But those goals are naturally contradictory. Interactivity means downloading JavaScript, and downloading JavaScript makes websites slower and less responsive. React is a great solution for creating complex interfaces, but in standalone React, you have to download all the code before showing any interface. From the user's perspective, your website is slow. And from the search engine bot's perspective, your website is expensive to read. The solution developed by Next.js in collaboration with React is to do the initial render on the server. This is what's called server-side rendering, or SSR. This way, the client sees the interface and the text before the app downloads any code. And search engine bots have a much easier job indexing the page. However, once the browser receives the HTML, it downloads the JavaScript from the server and restarts the application in a phase called hydration. Once hydration is complete, the browser takes responsibility for the rendering, and to do so, it re-renders the application to synchronize itself with the server. This means that the browser does the same rendering work that the server has just done before being interactive. The same work is being done twice, once on the server and once on the client to catch up with the server. Instead of downloading the framework and running the same render the server has just run, Qwik does something different. Qwik's output contains almost no JavaScript and doesn't do any hydration, and this results in blazingly fast performance. How does Qwik achieve that? Why is Qwik revolutionary? Qwik has two tricks up its sleeve. It does dynamic tree shaking and resumable rendering. How? Let's talk about how a page ends up on the browser. Like Svelte, the first place where the magic happens is in the compilation phase. Here, Qwik breaks up all the application code into small bundles. In Qwik, every closure, basically every block of code, can become a chunk. This is done using a compiler in Rust, which identifies when each piece of code is called. The bits of code that are never called and stuff like comments are discarded. This is basic tree shaking, which every compiler does. However, the Qwik compiler also identifies which bits of code are only called in the initial render and which are required for additional interactivity. What does it do with those chunks? Well, first it renders the page, and then it discards the chunks for the rendering. The other chunks? Well, let's see. A few things are worth noting here. First, like React and Solid, Qwik uses the JSX syntax to define the HTML output. However, unlike React, Angular, Solid, or Svelte, Qwik is a server-side framework. In a sense, Qwik is closer to Next.js than it is to React. Like Next.js, Qwik does a render of the HTML output using the JavaScript code. However, unlike Next.js, Qwik doesn't just care about rendering, it also cares about lazy loading, about chunks, about entry points, about serializing the state and resuming it. Let's talk about that last bit. Compared to Next.js, Qwik sends more information in the HTML output and sends less JavaScript code. Qwik records the framework state in the HTML sent to the client. That's the first step towards resumability. That state includes component boundaries, event listeners, and the application state. The second step is that every interactive bit of the interface holds a reference to the small chunk of code we mentioned earlier. That reference is a link to the JavaScript code. The final piece of the resumability puzzle is a small 1 kilobyte Qwik loader. This uses web workers to download the small chunks of JavaScript produced in the first phase by the compiler, the tiny bits that the page needs to be interactive. The loader does this in the background without using up the main thread. This is basically how Party Town works. No surprises there, since it's developed by Builder.io, as is Qwik. Not only is the JavaScript code lazy loaded, but it's also lazily executed. It's exactly as if the required JavaScript was streamed to the browser when it's needed, instead of as a big chunk. In fact, this reminds me of the difference between downloading and streaming a movie. There's a streaming protocol called HLS. This works by cutting up the movie into tiny pieces that are then served via HTTP. Streaming a movie means downloading the sequence of the tiny bits of the movie, and you only need to download the bits coming after where you're at in the movie. You can resume playing wherever you want. The compiler, the optimizer, is like the compressor that produces the tiny bits. The Qwik loader is like the video player that fetches the chunks that it needs. This is what allows Qwik to be so fast and so responsive. It's actually streaming the framework. So, is Qwik worth learning? We already have about a bazillion frameworks fighting for developer mindshare. Is there really any point in learning a new one? I mean, I'm already at something like 97% speed score on my Next.js-based website. Do I really need 100? Well, I have two answers to this question. First, I'm personally satisfied with 97%. Sure, Qwik will get me 3 percentage points more, but Next.js comes with a rich ecosystem. It's the reference implementation of React. Next.js has plenty of libraries that allow me to do everything that I need to do. The documentation goes deep and there's numerous resources. All that is missing from Qwik, so I don't think I'll be using Qwik for any serious projects in the short term. However, and this is a big however, I do believe the way Qwik is doing things is the future. This means that it's important to understand how Qwik works, how it's structured, where the magic lies, and what that structure implies in terms of how we code, particularly what happens to our variables when the code is split up into tiny bits. However, I don't think we'll all be using Qwik in the future, but it is likely that React and Next.js will be, shall we say, inspired by Qwik's innovations, and learning Qwik will give you a head start and a new perspective as to how frameworks work. So yes, I do believe it's a good idea to learn Qwik, which brings me to my next point, how to learn Qwik. If, like me, you're interested in learning more, I recommend the free course created by Qwik and featuring Mishko, where he explains why Qwik exists and how to use it. You can find it at qwikschool.com. The Qwik website documentation is also very instructive. The section on resumability versus hydration is particularly interesting. And there are also several interesting podcasts, one entitled Qwik is a New Kind of Framework, another Qwik has the Right Amount of Magic. And in any case, I'll see you in the next video.